This weekend wouldn't exist without all of you, but most importantly, our parents, Nick and Beverly Farrow, and Chris and Judy Lee. So I just want to give them a hand. And here's to a great weekend. Thank you.
Sort of something real. I'm so in love with you. You can call me foolish, or call me anytime you like. I'll be right over. I'm yours, girl. I'm so in love with you. Can't take my eyes off you. Couldn't take my eyes away for a moment. Not a minute if I had to. I'm so in love with you. Kinda crazy, crazy feeling. Simple sort of something real. I'm so in love with you.
Nearly 5 years ago, before the resort was even built, this bride and groom fell in love with this beach just as they were falling in love with each other. And they decided that very day that if they got married, they wanted it to be on this beach. People they love have traveled from all over the world to and taken time out of their lives to be here on this special day. Looking out on paradise, this wonderful group of people, I think we can all understand what Kelley and Dave were thinking 5 years ago.
I'm so in love with you. Can't take my eyes off you. Take my eyes away for a moment. Not a minute if I had to. I'm so in love with you. Kinda crazy, crazy feeling. Simple sort of something real. I'm so in love with you.
Dave and Kelley, I just wanted to congratulate you on this very special and a little bit wet day. I'm going to read you some words. I don't dare to sing it, although I do know it and I do practice in the shower. This is by Billy Joel. So, don't go changing to try and please me. You never let me down before. don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore. I would not leave you in times of trouble. We never could have come this far. I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, I'll take you just the way you are.
I have not known a single night when your visage did not accompany me to sleep. There has not been a morning when you did not flutter behind my waking eyelids. I love you, okay? Want it louder? I love you. Spell it out, should I? I-L-O-V-E-Y-O-U. Want it backwards? You love I.
Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping, for only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together, for the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow.
If ever there is tomorrow when we are not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, you're stronger than you seem, and you're smarter than you think. But most importantly, even if we are apart, I will always be with you.
You're the reason that I smile getting off every plane. The reason that I smile every day. Your extremely generous heart inspires me. Your hunger for knowledge motivates me. You're the sharpest guy that I know, and your quick wit never ceases to amaze me. Your boyish zest for life is infectious, and you transform even the simplest moments into something special. Your unfailing encouragement has made me a stronger person than I ever knew I could be. You challenge me, you inspire me, you surprise me, and you impress me. You've accomplished so much, and I know that you will only do even bigger and greater things in life. You make me laugh every single day, and your freckles are pretty cute too. And you are good. You're great, you're handsome, you're charming, but I know, as most everyone here knows today, that you are thoroughly, unrelentingly, stubbornly a very good person. Before you, I didn't realize that there could be another person that saw the world the same way that I do, and that shared the same humor and the same values and appreciation for making each moment count. I'm so proud to know you, and let alone be with you. I truly am the luckiest girl in the world.
I'll never forget the first time we said I love you. We were running in the pouring rain to the streets of New York, trying, like always, to get to a party. We stopped under an awning for shelter and, for whatever reason, to profess our love for each other. It was the most romantic moment of my life, until right now. The truth is that I fell in love with you much earlier than that. It was 2 weeks after our first date, actually. I know at that moment, driving back from a weekend in Vermont, that I would do anything in my power to spend the rest of my life with you. Like most stubborn men, this meant spending the next 3 months being strategically aloof. I just couldn't believe that someone like you would give me a second look, let alone want to be seen in public with me. It's obvious to everyone on this beach today how stunning you are, but only I know how, deep down, how truly beautiful you are. You continue to floor me in new ways every day. Your kindness, your big heart, your unrelenting drive and focus, your unflinching optimism, your passion for squeezing the most out of every single moment inspire me every day. Over the last 7 years, you have made me a better person, and trying to live up to your example gets me through even the toughest moments. I get to wake up every morning next to my idol and go to sleep every night next to my soulmate. I fall more in love with you every day, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you.
Now, by the power vested in me, it is my honor to declare you husband and wife. Maybe make us the bride.
The night I that I could speak to, a dream that I can call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I
So there's been many special moments in our lives, and this is certainly one of them. And I thank you all for being part of it. She also told me last night, keep it short, Dad. So with that, let's toast to the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. David Kelley Lee.
Kelley and Dave, I don't know where your future travels will bring you or where your future home will be, but I do know that it will be happy, fun, and full of heart. And after seeing you guys today, I cannot imagine a home filled with more love. So please raise your glasses and help me wish Kelley a Kelley and Dave a lifetime of health and happiness.
They have this infectious enthusiasm about them that I think everyone here knows just makes everyone feel better. You always want to be around them. That's why everybody's here tonight. So I do hope you move back east. I know my parents are going to harass you about that daily, as well as children daily. And the Pharaohs, probably more than daily, it looks like. I'll end this with one thing. When I met my wife, it was our second time kind of going out together. And we met Dave and Kelley at a bar late in New York City. And Dave pulled my wife aside after a couple drinks and he said, hey, thanks for hanging out with my brother, which is really inspiring. So tonight, Kelley, I want to say thanks for hanging out with my brother. We couldn't be happier for you guys. We love you to death. We know you'll have all the happiness in the world, so thank you so much.
Don't you dare look.